Well, good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Thank you. So the Pope is speaking to Congress this morning, and I'm speaking to you. So I think we're at parity already for the day, don't you think? All right. Anyways, listen, my name is Stu Kulinski. I'm the VP of Sales for IP Phone. We're really, really, really happy to be in alignment with TCG for about 7 or 8, maybe 9 months now. And we've got a lot of activity going. We're delighted about it. And, you know, it's going to be a great relationship. So before I get started here, I'd just like to give the inaugural cap to Dan and the accompanying IP Phone shirt.
Oh, wow.
All right?
All right.
Huh? It'll fit you? One size fits. Don't wash it in warm water, baby. All right?
This is why we signed the deal with them.
Yeah. Yeah, it's all about the shirts. Shirts and collateral and gift cards. All right? Anyways, everybody would agree with, I have a presentation for you today. It's you'll probably notice real quickly that I talk very, very fast. So the number of slides are not going to be intimidating. I have 92 of them, all right? I can rattle them off in a pretty, pretty rapid fire fashion. You'll see as we get started here. I've been in the telecommunications industry for 45 years, and I started when I was 12, all right? So you figure it out. Anyways, that being said, I've been with IP Phone for about 8 years, and of course I have my cohort here. Eric, please bring me to the demo, Levitt, all right? And I'll tell you why that's an important nickname as time goes on today, as we find out, you know, some of the good strategies in how you can increase your closing ratio selling really whatever it is you're selling, all right? But particularly today, hosted. So everybody agrees with the euphemism that knowledge is power. Would you all agree with that?
Yes.
Okay. So, you know, having these lunches, lunch and learns are really a good thing for everybody, because the more you know, the better off you're going to be. We're all going to be in this industry a long time. We're going to be in sales a long time. And we're going to represent companies that the more you know about them, the better off you are, especially when you suggest to your clients that this is a good move for them. Hi, Alan. All right. So that being said, we're going to talk about the three phases that I just mentioned to you. And it's going to go through from a broad-based scope about IP Phone, move into the industry that we're in, and then talk about some of the strategies and tactics of how to get customers to yes, all right? And some of the things that you can do to motivate them. So let's get going here. Okay, IP Phone, the company, just real quickly, has been in business for 18 years. We're headquartered in North Miami. This is for your edification, for some of you who are new to us. We're a CLAC. We have rate centers all over the world. We do SIP trunking, hosted PBX, and dedicated bandwidth. We have a complete product suite, as you can say, 24/7 support, which is, you know, sort of redundant in today's world. Everybody sort of has it. Depends how you give it. We have a 99% retention rate, boasting about 2,000 logoed customers, about 40,000 seats in service right now, just on the hosted PBX side. We have dedicated personnel. One of the nice things that I know TCG favors us with is the fact that we have all of our own trucks. We have 5 trucks on the road, 5 technicians, 4 project managers, and a partridge in a pear tree. We have a fully redundant network, which I'm very, very pleased to announce today, that, you know, we've been in the Terramark building for 12 years, backed up at peak 10. But our CEO last week signed a deal in New Jersey, just outside of the Lincoln Tunnel in New Jersey, in Secaucus, at a data center. So we are now deploying, it'll be deployed in 30 to 45 days, a fully redundant BroadSoft platform. It's about a $250,000 investment, you know, well needed, well, many times asked for, but now will be implemented for total disaster recovery and redundancy. All right? So we're very happy to do that, which shows the commitment of the company to being in the business for a long time. We also have a unique feature that all of our customers, and some of you know, get a fully blown 6-month guarantee on all of our services, regardless of what they are. So in effect, when you sign a 2 or 3 year deal with a customer, the deal really doesn't start in their mind, if you will, until 6 months down the road, and then there's only 18 months left on the 24. But we backed it up. We've only had to use it one time, and I keyed that guy's car so hard. What? You wouldn't? All right. So we have the distinction, along with about 500 other companies, of winning the 2015 Unified Communications Award as the product, one of the products of the year. And the reason I put this up here is that Unified Communications is going to be the holy grail in the next 5 years in terms of customer implementation of mobility to hosted services to cloud-based services. And you got to know about this stuff. And I would say right now that only about 2 out of 10 of the implementations that we do include Unified Communications, integrated mobility, chat, presence, and all those kinds of things. And I think that's going to change. And the faster you get on board with knowing what these products are and asking your customers if those would be helpful to them, you will sell more and your MRC will go through the roof on top of that, all right? So, IP Phone News, just to round it out here, we have a new product, IP Phone Virtual Fax, in and out faxed, unlimited long distance, anywhere in the United States, $12 a month per user, period. Okay, it's on the table right now. It replaces eFax, it replaces a lot of our fax box services that we had, so it's virtual fax in total. We just hired a channel manager in North Florida. His name is Bob D'Angelo. So we're expanding our wings a little bit, and we've already communicated with a lot of the TCG agents from Orlando and up to get them on board. So we have a physical presence for demos, for you know all the things that a channel manager would do up there. Lately, we've got a lot of talk and a lot of desire to talk about and larger deals specifically for CRM implementation and integration. Okay, companies now are using CRMs. You know, Salesforce is the iconic one, of course, but there are 10 or 15 others that are being used universally. We've done several implementations so far. They've gone very, very well. It's not the cheapest thing that you can do, but customers want it and are willing to pay for it so they can have click-to-dial customer information on their screen when taking particularly in call center situations and outbound sales situations. Voice recording. Everybody has voice recording. We just added a new wrinkle to it. It's got an evaluation function. There is a survey that will actually come on the screen after the employee is listened to, if you will. And the supervisor can then fill in the blanks so when they do a one-on-one with their employees about how they're doing on the phone, they can actually show them this evaluation, fill it out real time. Nice wrinkle. Mobile integration, again, is a big-time thing. You know, we're going to talk about unified communications and mobile link in just a little bit because the world is going to change. Nobody's going to have an office in the next 5 years, just the way it is. Most of you work from home as it is. Okay? No, Bud Light. All right? Again, the newly redundant data center in New Jersey is coming about, and we have tested in our labs very recently and have now approved for sale, which we do for all of our products, the Panasonic line of handsets. If you're unfamiliar with them, we have them. We'll bring some over to the office. You can look at them, demo them, what have you. They're pretty robust and have a pretty nice profile as an executive touchscreen phone. All right, we also got 5 new trucks. The other ones had about 150,000 miles apiece on them. These are bigger, better. Hopefully you've seen them on the street. Some of you also may have seen on the street, we do some advertising now on Biscayne. You know, those sort of lollipop, icons that are there, those little billboards. Got a lot of play on those. All right, so our portfolio, just real quickly to reiterate, is Cloud PBX call centers, which are really, really big time, all right? We have become, I won't say experts, but pretty close to that on the deployment of call centers, all right? I know Paul's done a couple with us now, and we have 7 or 8 major deployments with north of 100 call center agents in service right now, and many, many smaller ones as well. All right? It's a whole technique and a whole demo situation that goes into that for the hosted call center. High-speed internet, we AT&T, FPL, and the like, we resell all these, but we take a single vendor concept to all of our deployments. If you have an address and you want a quote on a data circuit or a fiber or a T1, all we need is the address. We get you the price, either incorporated into the quote or as an aside, whichever you prefer.
Won't give that to us? Can we use that?
No. I mean, it might even be a universal application for all I know, but I'm not sure that that will, supply it for you. We'd rather do it, tell you the truth, because, if it's a competitive situation, we can move and make moves, adds, and changes on that, as well as some of you well know. All right? Here's the list of voice services, and then, of course, the bandwidth services. Okay, applications. Mobile integration on iOS and Android. If you don't have it yet, Paul?
Stu, one of the things that a lot of carriers don't do that you guys do, when you order a Metro E circuit from IP Phone, they will put in temporary T1s for a customer.
Thank you, appreciate that. We will. I just mentioned it to the gentleman that back there. Yeah, fiber from AT&T, just to isolate that. Generally, it takes 90 to 120 days to deploy, maybe even longer, depending on where they are in their infrastructure and what they're in the mood to do, frankly. All right? We will put in 2, 3, 4 T1s bonded in the interim. So the customer can have the choice of having those while the deployment is being taken place. And once it's happened, these T1s come out with no penalty.
Do you supply the routers with the T1 card?
Yep, absolutely.
Cool.
But in terms of getting charged, it's like for bonded T1?
Yeah, you pay, it's like, you know, it's anywhere from $250 to $270, yeah, depending on the distance again, per T.
Okay.
But it's a customer choice.
You guys,
and most people, frankly, do it, okay? Because it's worth it to them, because they need it, all right? Because what they have now is either too slow, not working, or hiccuping up and down the street, all right?
You guys also offer an SLA on the FBB.
We have an SLA on every product we deploy, period. It's on our website, and we have it in writing. Every single product is SLA'd, okay, that we sell.
Well, all right? But if you're reselling the FBB, I was told that you guys have the SLA also on the FBB, while AT&T does not offer.
We do. Yeah, and the 6-month guarantee.
Right.
All right? Anything else? Huh? Want me to wash your car?
Sure.
For crying out loud? All right. All right. So I told you about the CRM, the voice recording. We have fax solutions. We do have the fax box. We have the new product coming out real quickly. We do virtual numbers, toll-free numbers, all the telephony services that have been available for years and years and years. So one of the things I'm going to talk to you about later, by the way, is not to neglect those ancillary services, because you get paid, all right? And the customer needs it. They want a single vendor, and I suggest to you that you're missing out on hundreds of dollars of MRC per month, per customer in some cases, all right? How about overhead paging? I can't tell you how many times we have to go back, we can do the deployment, the customer says, well, how am I gonna page now? Oh, you have paging? Damn, we didn't really know that. But it's incumbent upon all of us collectively to find out if they have it, because they need to get a user license and they need a little bit of equipment. And then they can press a button on any phone and page. All right?
But you can still use the pager over the phones themselves.
Over the phones you can. And now Polycom has a built-in to the phone paging. But if they have overhead paging in a warehouse, I mean, and they're used to having it, we have that. But we need to know so that the project can run smoothly. All right, so you need to find out this kind of information instead of just how many seats and how many HLD and, you know, and what's the bandwidth.
Do they have to get the equipment, or do we
provide? We get it for them.
You'll provide
them the equipment. It's a PAP2 and some other piece of gear and a Viking, We probably have done 500 of them, not to mention doorbells. I mean, we do some of this stuff. Our technicians.
Huh? Smart doorbells?
Yeah. The alarms.
Gates.
Gates, everything. We do it.
You integrate everything.
Bill Gates, I don't care what you got.
Bill Gates
for the Bill Gates.
Hey, analog lines also, do you guys pay residual?
I'm not sure.
Yes.
Okay, maybe a little bit, maybe half a point.
If you're
all right?
Agent.
Yeah, it depends. Analog lines, by the way, the business that we're in, guys, most customers are trying to get rid of it in some fashion or way. By 2017 or 18, they're going to go bye-bye anyways. But we do have them. We can do them two ways just to go on. We can either convert the ones they have, you know, port the numbers. We bill it because we represent AT&T as an agent. Or if they want new analog lines, we can order them on their behalf via AT&T. Okay? Within the LATA.
You only use AT&T.
Right. Within the 460 LATA.
And it's $40 per analog line.
Plus tax, which makes it 140. Okay? Why? You know that. You were born at night, but not last night. I know that. All right? You know, when they say, well, how much are the taxes? It's going to be about 20%. You know, give or take 20%. Oh, it's disgusting. All right? Edit that. All right? Toll-free and virtual numbers, you know, we do business globally. So if you have virtual numbers, you want to put a number in Rio de Janeiro for marketing purposes, if your company wants to do that, we have them. It's $10 a month per circuit. And they everywhere. Almost everywhere. Almost everywhere. There's a list.
Okay, you don't have to have an actual physical office in China to get numbers?
No.
Okay, because most carriers...
Yeah, you have to. We'll have to look at the particular country, and I'm not going to bet on China, but I don't know, all right?
Okay.
The president's in town like right now. Let me make a call, all right? All right, so everybody knows that the hotel-motel business is in full stride. Mm-hmm. BroadSoft bought a company called Jazz, which is headquartered up here in Del Rey. Jazz is now a BroadSoft company, all right, wholly owned, and all the people who work for Jazz are now part of BroadSoft. So just to give you a thumbnail, the hotel-motel industry is morphing towards hosted PBXs, getting rid of old legacy PBXs, just like enterprise, just like commercial. new hotels that are going in right now are going in with hosted PBX instead of, you know, premise-based, all right, because it's a lot easier. So we have formula, and I'm very happy to say we have, and we've done two or three hotels. I'm very happy to say that we just did this Big Mama in Punta Cana, 800 rooms, and they just added 80 more rooms. You finished doing your calculations? Okay, that's what I thought. All right, plus another 75 admin phones, yada, yada, yada. We invested $100,000 as a company in all the audio codes, the racks. We shipped it over there. I mean, this is the Mac Daddy deal, all right? So imagine if you have the Notel Motel in Vero Beach, all right? We've all stayed that once or twice. All right, so we did this system. It was a Avaya replacement, and they couldn't be any happier. Customer support, I'm not going to belabor the point. We have good customer support, tiers 1, 2, and 3, an escalation list that is only this long. Every one of our customers is open to having our escalation list, and the people at the bottom, we have the CEO, you can call his mobile phone if you need to.
As Renee knows.
Okay, as Renee knows. He's changing his number. He only gave Renee 9 digits. All right? Anyways, here's our 6-month satisfaction guarantee, ladies and gentlemen.
I gave you one. which one?
Here's our 6-month satisfaction guarantee. It says if we can't fix the issue that any customer is having, you know, if they want us to take our stuff and go home, we'll take it. It's just the way it is. It's a nice, you know, comfort thing, because everybody knows that the tribulation of changing from one phone system to another phone system, regardless of what it is hair-raising for the buyer. Which is why most of them end up staying with the status quo, because they don't want to go through the hell or the pain, because they've gone through it before and they don't want it again. So we've added this to ease their pain. All right, just real quickly, you know, we have a full-blown partner desk, help desk for all you people. We'll do your quotes for you. We'll edit them. We'll revise them. We'll do all the things you need to get it done. All right, we're dedicated to it. We are in the position to implement products and services anywhere on the planet. All right, we have deployments in, I think, 5 continents right now. You know, a lot of them in the Caribbean, South America, Mexico, you know, places like this, some over in Europe, whatever the case may be, and of course anywhere domestically. All right, we'll do the job. If the job demands it, we'll send our techs to the location. They'll get on the airplane. We have techs right now in Dallas putting in 18 phones for one of our large customers who did a deployment. Boom, no questions asked. All right? All right, here's some of our logos. We've been in business a long time, sort of a who's who. There's a lot more to go into it, but these are the ones that people sort of understand. So again, we have locations basically everywhere. So let's talk about why to sell hosted PBX. All right? All companies will have VoIP. Can't think of a better reason. Can you? 30% have it now. I know you're doing the math here, all right? 30% of enterprise users in the United States have hosted PBX, okay? Now, that's a big number because there's, you know, millions of companies, which means there are hundreds of thousands or millions of people who have it. But 70% of the businesses out there have not transitioned to the service. And they will. They will when something happens that forces the issue on them. Am I correct? Right? I'll talk to you about some of those drivers in just a little while, but they will all move. And you folks are going to be in this business probably for how long?
Until I can't move.
I got you, babe. Until they throw you out. It's just the way it is. We're going to be here. We're going to be in it to stay. So I would suggest that if you're not paying vital attention to this migration of billions of dollars of services, that you're going to miss the boat. You're going to be left behind. Okay? And I'm talking about drilling down deep to, you know, a lot of the stuff that I'm going to talk to you about in the next little while. Companies change PBXs about every 7 to 10 years. There's a paradigm shift, all right? We are in that one right now. So here's the bottom line for you folks as entrepreneurial salespeople in this industry. If you don't sell them, somebody else is going to. Is that a fair statement?
Yes.
All right? So you might as well do everything in your power to get the deal when it's available, okay? And it makes you a better consultant. It should have been consultant, all right? But it makes you a better one when you know more, because knowledge is power. Would you agree? And when you know how to ask the right questions or dig into somebody's business a little bit to find out what's going to be helpful to them, because they don't always want to spend the cheapest amount. They want the one that will make their business what?
Better.
And if you go in with that attitude, I think you'll sell more anyways. All right? All right, let's move on. All right, so there's three parts to hosted telephony. Everybody knows them. There's the software platform. We use BroadSoft. There's the bandwidth, you know, everybody talking, you know, the dedicated services. Everybody knows that, you know, from our point of view, we encourage dedicated bandwidth for any company with more than 5 users. All right? It's a better experience and you won't get all the calls. That's just how we feel. You make your choices. And lastly, of course, are the endpoints, which we're basically agnostic to. We offer endpoints, we offer Polycom, you know, Yealink phones, which is a pretty cool new line of phones, and Panasonic. And if you have your own, which we're starting to get a lot of now, people are moving from one hosted company to another, we can just use their phones. Okay? I'm going to blow through this pretty fast. And I got to tell you something. You know, I've been doing this for a long time, so I know this stuff. All right? And these are the things that, why this is a good business to be in and why we should sell it. I'm not going to list them all. Are most of you agreeing with most of these? Is anybody reading them? This took me an hour, okay? Is it logical versus premise-based? Isn't it logical, do you think?
Sorry, what do you mean by incumbent bandwidth?
You can, if you have a Metro E with some, with AT&T now, you can just use it, and you use the bandwidth that you have. We put a QoS, a bring your own bandwidth, if you like, okay? I like the word incumbent because it makes me feel like I actually graduated college. If you text me, it's BYOB. All right? Supported remotely, that's one of the nicest things. If somebody's if a law firm doesn't want to fool with phones, we fool with phones. That's what we do, correct? They don't want to fool with phones. They don't want to hire somebody to fool with phones. They don't want to pay monthly for someone to fool with phones. They want us to do it. And they want to practice what?
Law.
I said lawyers. Oh. All right. It makes businesses more responsive. The implementation of unified communication services makes businesses better. How do you feel when you miss a phone call? Huh? If you don't answer the phone, who's going to answer it? Somebody else is going to answer it. That's the oldest cliche in the books, right?
Not if they're trying to start.
I mean, if something goes to voicemail, how do you know? I take every call, except Eric.
Caller ID.
All right? Manageable. It's feature rich. I mean, without going through it, you've seen the feature pages of premium, standard, and extension licenses. There's too many to go through. And by the way, if you show a potential buyer all the features that are available on the premium service, the guy or woman's head will roll back in their head. Do not do that. I don't even get it. And I'm doing it. All right? Okay, it's very affordable. You know, the monthly recurring OPEX environment is very appealing for people instead of writing a big check. Everybody knows that. It's flexible. You can scale up, scale down. If your company moves, you can put the phones in a box, plug them in next door where you're going. Piece of cake. No more forklifting. Okay? Easy to scale up or down. We have an interesting deal that if a company has 80 phones with us and they fire 2 people and go to 78, we'll only bill them for 78 as long as they tell us. Okay? Up or down. Now, if they go out of business, they're getting a big one. All right? We scaled from 80 to 0. All right? Great voice quality. Nobody can talk anymore about the voice quality. It is good. All right? Generally speaking, but there's an old saying that you're only as good as your bandwidth. Yep. You agree with that? Thank you. Very nice. All right. It unifies all workers. Again, you know, the changing business environment is going to be such that people are going to work in other places. We have customers right now who have workers in Paris, France, as a call center agent for French-speaking people, and they're in Paris. Okay? Enjoying the parasites. But they're over there, and they answer the phone as if they're sitting in the middle of Hollywood. All right? Business continuity. Everybody knows business continuity, disaster recovery. Eric has a great thing when you bring him on a call. He scares the customer out of their mind, don't you? Just by walking in. But then he shows them what he has. Let me see if there's any more. And it's, frankly, lastly, it's the only way to go. It's here to stay. Universal features for all. Single vendor concept. So the auto attendant is in the cloud. Best thing. What's the benefit of having the auto attendant in the cloud? Huh? No. I mean, that's a good idea, but by having your auto attendant in the cloud, what is the biggest benefit to the customer?
You're always up.
They will never not get a call. Agreed? You could be closed down, your building could collapse, but someone can leave a voicemail message for you.
Speaking of voicemail,
huh?
Do you guys have voice to text for your email, for your voicemail?
It's an optional feature.
Okay.
Okay? All right, let me go on. Sorry, I didn't mean to go to the dark side.
Yeah. Optional feature that costs more, optional feature that they can turn on.
It costs. There's a cost to it.
$5.
I'm not sure what it is. But
I think it's free. $5.
Hmm?
Not
free.
Per user? $5.
Is it per user?
It's per user, per yeah. User. Okay? All right. And last but not least, I highlighted it. It is highly sellable. Every business person knows somebody who has Cloud PBX. The cat is out of the bag. People are talking about it. That's all they want. They ask you for it. Is that a fair statement? Generally speaking, they don't ask for, you have a big system that I can buy something in the $100,000 range, right? That might take 4 weeks to put in. I need all these guys here and rewire my business. Come on, I know you have something like that. Bring it on. All right. So why sell hosted UC? First of all, I'm going to tell you this is not the future. When I first did some of these slides, it was in the embryo stage of unified communications. It was just coming about, all right? How many of you have the app on your smartphone for unified communications? For anybody, right? If you don't have it, ladies and gentlemen, you need to get it. How in the world can you show somebody this cool app that lets you take your desk phone while you're driving in your car and take your business persona with you, all right? We have a product called Mobile Link, which allows you to use your cellular network. We're including it now on every seat except extension. That allows you to use the cellular network, which is even more comprehensive than the data network, to make business calls and have all the same information that you have on your desk phone on your smartphone. And everybody be loving it.
That's a very important point because...
Oh, thank you again. He's looking for a gift card.
But most of the other providers don't offer the one that goes over your cellular network.
Yeah.
Over data. And
yeah.
Really, the quality...
So don't tell anybody about it, would you? Just clam up and sell ours. Clam up and sell ours, okay? Anyways...
Can you go run through that one more time?
Yeah. The Unified Communications app. I have a slide of it. I don't have it now, but... It's right here. This dial pad is the same dial pad that I have in my home and my office. Now I have it on my smartphone. It's got my contact list, recently called numbers, everything. And when I call you, the number you will see will not be my cell phone. It will be my what?
Your office phone?
My office phone.
Wait,
because I don't want you to have my cell phone number.
It's still going over the cellular data.
This is cellular.
Data.
There's two. Let me cut to the chase here. UC, the UC Basic, if I was to choose UC Basic or Mobile Link, if I don't travel overseas, is a better product. UC Basic for overseas, because you won't get roaming charges. Okay? We can go over all this. I have flyers on it. You know, you can dig a little deeper. But if you don't, you got to have it on your phone, guys. This is rule number two.
Is the UI the same? Like, does it look exactly the same as the data version? Or?
Yeah, it's exactly the same. All right, just a different...
Texting?
No.
Well, the advanced UC has presence, chat, video, everything.
Okay.
You know, you pay for those features as you go up. All right? We have flyers on all that you can, look into.
The basic included, but if they want additional
Mobile
features.
Link is included. Basic UC is $5.
Okay.
Okay, which is a BroadSoft product. Mm-hmm. All right? All right, let's go on. Where are we at? Okay, so it is very highly receptive. You know, people like to see it now, and we're starting to get more and more clients that are ordering it incumbent with their new PBXs, and the price goes up a little bit. They're paying for it, right? But you know what? They like it because they like the fact that they can do extension dialing from here to Chicago when they travel. Extension dialing. They go, whoa.
From their phone.
From their phone. Now you're catching on. All right? All right. It pulls other services through. You know, if you're competing with something else or if they're reticent about the change, this could be where the hot button lies. Okay? This could be their pain point. I got people all over the place who can't reach anybody, what have you. It eliminates the long distance, does it not? I'm doing extension dialing worldwide. Okay? All right. So it makes the customer a little stickier because they're using more services. All right? Here's one of the reasons why we want to continue to sell VoIP. All right? Number one, look at the graph and the money that's available from 2013 to 2018. This is in the billions of dollars. Ladies and gentlemen, you got to get your own private Idaho out of this. You deserve some of this, would you say?
Oh, yeah.
How long you been selling this stuff?
Just started.
Just, yeah, right, yeah. How long you been selling?
Almost 3 years.
You got the whole rest of your life to sell this. Think about that. And then I'll ask you what keeps you up at night. Okay? So the opportunity for all of you money-grabbing salespeople is billions of dollars. Don't wait. Get your share. People are buying these things all over the place. I mean, you know how many people sell this stuff? There's tens of thousands. You're just the channel partners. You see all those people out there? They're doing it. Okay? The interesting part is not many are, because not many understand how to do it, which we'll get into in a moment thoroughly. Favorable, the economy is improving. Miami is a technology hub. Everybody wants to be at the latest end. Competition is fierce. Cloud services in general are becoming more accepted. It's just commonplace anymore. And many firms are expanding. What's the benefit of why is it good to look at hosted when they're expanding?
Easier growth.
Scalable.
Yeah, it's scalable. They can have phones in how long when they grow? Week, week and a half? Up and running. We just, you know, just ship them out there or bring someone out to install them, just the way it is. Our company, particularly, we've been in business for, you know, doing this for 12 years. 50% of the licenses that we sell per month are add-ons. Everybody capisce that? 50% of the new licenses we sell, one here, two here, three here, one here, four here, one here, one here, one here. The list is like this. And eventually, when you start getting 20, 30, 40 customers with PBXs, they will also start to do what? To add on. And if they're doing business with us, if they call us to do it and just add it for them, it goes under your code, under the TCG code. It's all automated. All right? So it's a beautiful business because it automatically grows. All right? How many of you have had customers that say, yeah, we're opening an office in Chicago, we're expanding, right? Boom, you can handle them wherever they are on the planet. Here are some of the purchasing drivers that gets people going and looking for and motivated to look at a new phone system. Their current one just goes down, right? Number two is they're gonna open a new office. It's a great time to consider an enterprise view. They want mobile employees. They wanna figure out how to corral the people that work out in the street. They merge, companies combine, all right? Companies separate. You know, any activity, as everybody getting this, any event generally motivates them. And that's what the problem, and the biggest issue and the challenge we have is finding out when people are ready to do it, right? But they will never call you if you haven't approached them. Call them, you know, once this happens, let me know. I mean, it's that kind of thing. Let me be your go-to person. Okay? New devices are enabled. People are seeing, like just like I showed you, there are people that are showing their friends all this stuff and they want it too. All right? And their current PBX is limited. You ever hear anybody ever tell you, yeah, my phone system works? Right? Yeah, it works.
Oh, so you're on the
but you know what? You know what my comeback line is? But does it work for you? And they go, what do you think they say? Well, what do you mean by that? That's all I need to see is to get my foot in that door. They're done. They are done. All right? Because then I can talk about all this stuff that they're not getting, but they're already paying for. And I'll show it to you in a minute. All right. This is out of a Channel Partner Magazine. Just a real quickie, just to let you know that I'm not making this stuff up, although I could. All right? The number one reason why people are buying is because their system is getting old. All right? Number two is lack of routing functionality. You know, calls are getting lost. They're going into the abyss. They're going to voicemail. People are hanging up on them. Right? You know, we pride ourselves in doing a deep dive into the call flow of our buyers to make sure that when I say, Paul, where do you want this call to go once it reaches your auto attendant? I want it to ring here three times if nobody picks it up, and I want it to go to Stu. If Stu's not there, I want it to go to Eric. And we arrange all that pre-install. OK? Okay? Okay, so why is business going hosted? It's future-proof. It's complete, simple. I love it, by the way. The OpEx is the big thing, no money down. We have a rent-to-own program that after 3 years you own the phones, the rental price goes away, period. No $1 buyout, no continual phone rental. It's over. And it basically comes down to the actual price of the phone plus about three to five points for admin. Okay, it's feature-rich. I went through some of this. Okay, here's the key point. You have to tell your prospects that their competitors have this. Because if they don't have it and you do, and if they have it and you don't, right, they have a leg up on you because they're going to get more business. They're going to be more responsive and have all these features. Don't be afraid to say it. What happens if disaster strikes? Okay? And companies are looking to standardize. You have to use this terminology. Would it be a benefit to you to standardize your technology for all your locations? The answer is yes, you know that. How could they possibly say no? It's a motherhood question. We just know this. Does standardization seem like a good idea for you, right? When they have five or six locations with five or six different phone systems, right? How many bills are they getting with five or six different phone systems? From five different carriers, five different phone systems, five different, there's a million people involved in just accounting, all right? All that goes away. But we never really include that in our quote. We just tell them it's $400. And they go, I don't want to spend another $400. We'll get to that momentarily. Okay? This is Frost & Sullivan. You ever heard of them? Big-time consultant firm out of New York. I don't even know if it's a real company, but they always quote. In 10 years, the average work environment will be as foreign to people as it was, you know, some people living a century ago. In other words, I get Newsweek magazine. There was a big article about, you know, what office? Right? What office? And people are not going to work are not going to drive an hour every day like I do, miserably, to go to some cubbyhole and sit there, you know, and take calls. I'm going to do it from home. But in order to do that, I can't have a phone system sitting in my office someplace with a really long cord. Up 95, get off Palmetto Park Road, underground. There's little doubt that mobility is transferring business anywhere, anytime, via mobile devices. And I wrote that. Not really. I just crossed out the other guy's name. All right? Here's a big number. 84% of businesses are going to consider getting UC. Is that forceful enough for you to consider learning about it? 84%. I mean, that's a big number. It's basically everybody. All right? We talked about some of these. I'll just ramp this up. Those are the benefits of why customers are, those 84% are entertaining the product. Okay? And when I say unified communications, the PBX piece of it is incumbent to the environment. Ooh, that sounded really good. I like that. All right, the PBX is incumbent to the UC environment. It's unified communications. And we have customers now that want presence, chat, you know, video, everything. When we demo the VVX 500 and 600, we put the camera on it. And we show the camera, they go, ooh. Okay, whether they buy it or not, they go, ooh. You had me at ooh. All right, so UC keeps companies open. So if you have the mobile app, by the way, and your system goes down in your office, what do you got going? Yeah. It's another spoke in the wheel of disaster recovery, is it not?
Wait. Hold on. Isn't it, if you're, either the network goes down, meaning IP phone, just hypothetically, or the broadband provider, and your phones aren't registered.
It'll still go to this.
It's supposed to be a shared.
Yeah, because because it's simultaneous ring.
Yeah, but it's not going to ring on the desk phone.
It won't ring on the desk phone. It's going to ring here.
So it's different because if it's on an app, it's more like a shared line appearance versus a call forwarding unreachable.
Right.
So but is that treated as call forwarding
unreachable? Yes. My mobile link will ring if my phone is unplugged.
Is it going to ring through the app or is it going to ring to the mobile as a forwarding number?
I don't know. It just rings. I don't know. Eric, write that down.
I will.
Eric, get a pen. Hold on. Eric, get a pen and paper. I don't really know. Yeah.
It's through the app.
It's through the app. That's
yeah.
what I thought.
Yeah, it goes
it's
the
mobile.
You can
using the cellular network, by the way.
You can set it up to have simultaneous ring so that your desk and your mobile
yeah,
are ringing at the same time.
Your desk isn't going to ring. It's going to forward to your cell phone number. Which you set up on the back end through the
If you have call forwarding, but if you have your app
phone.
On, it's
going to
ring.
Doing the call forward.
It's going to ring to the phone.
You're doing the app.
One way or another,
it's going to ring to the phone.
But I was told that if your phone is down, it's not going to be able to ring through the app.
It will ring through the app.
The app has nothing to do with the handset.
That does. It's doing a share
nothing
line.
To do with handset.
You have to have
it's
a premium license, but it's not a shared line appearance. It's a shared device.
It's something called mirroring. Isn't that what it is?
I don't know what it is.
It has nothing to do with the handset.
Everybody says it's in the cloud.
Yeah, no, well, let me get back to you on that. Let me get back to you on that, all right? All right, I give you the gift card. Jeez. Holy crap. I'm sweating. My back is sweating. All right, let's keep going here. Anyways, it's good for business. Here, put this in your pipe and smoke it, which most of you are not that unaccustomed to. By the way, that's all of you at the bottom there. Okay. Okay, here's an easier way to explain it. In fully loaded unified communications, voice, video, messaging, presence, mobility, and collaboration via web. Those are the six or so major pieces of unified communications. Okay? Period. Okay? So the benefits are cost savings, business persona, we talked about that. Bring your own device, one number access, centralized control, secure communications, and all that. All right? This is what you say to customers. This is what it does for their business. And if they don't get that, you could be talking to the wrong person. If it's not that important to them, why should I buy this versus how much is it? I really prefer those people. Right, don't you? What will this do for me? I'd rather have that question than how much is it? Okay? Improves customer communications, and of course you can BYOD. That's my little Prius.
Device or data?
Kabish? Already? All right, let's go on. If you see what you see
does. Is Clooney up there?
Yes.
That's the gift card right there.
There's the Mac Daddy. He knows
yes.
who butters his bread. All right? Let me get back to this. If you see what UC does, then you see why business needs UC. Now you see what I'm talking about.
Yes.
Yeah, right there. What do you think I do in my spare time? If Renee's not calling me, I got nothing to do. All right. Here's IP Phone's take. This is our mantra. All right? This is how we encourage closing deals in our own troops, and we believe that this should translate to agents as well and the businesses that you're in. And this is universal information. I don't care if this is IP Phone. We believe that this is universally beneficial to whatever you sell, frankly, all right? And I'm sort of giving you what I think is, generic information in hopes that you'll turn it to us just because I gave it to you, but that's your call, all right? Okay? We do face-to-face meetings. We encourage and choose not to email proposals. What's the problem with emailing somebody a quote?
Nope.
Where's the ball? In whose court? It's in their court. What are some of the things they would do with that? Either not look at it, send it to the competitor, right? They won't understand it. Number two, right?
Well, yours is pretty simple.
It is simple. But you know what? There's things on there. So the benefit of bringing it to them allows you to review line item by line item what it is they're banking on here. And if they have a question about this, what is this? Maybe we can adjust. Maybe we can add two more. All right? Plus the fact that, by the way, you're not just selling a phone system. What are you selling? Your relationship with them. Why in the world would you send somebody something that's going to cost them $1,000 a month and hope for the best? This is your livelihood. This is your retirement we're talking about here. Get your butt out of the seat and go see the guy. And when they say, can you email it to me? What's the answer? No, how's 3 o'clock tomorrow afternoon for our half hour review?
Wait. But what if you do that part first?
And do what part first?
You meet with them first before you even email them.
Well, that's incoming. You've already done that. That's discovery.
So you're trying to get around emailing something to somebody.
Yeah.
Doesn't happen this day and age, man.
That's whose fault is that?
Listen, if you're good enough, you can still win it.
Do you think it's, well, some. Okay? Some.
I think it's great you guys go out.
We go out. I don't care if I get a deal myself in Chicago. If some guy's got 50 phones in Chicago, I'm in his face. I get a room for 3 nights. And hopefully I'm going back with ink.
There's no other way to do
it. No, I think it's great. I think it's great.
All right? I got to tell you, I'm going to give you some statistics momentarily. And by the way, this is all up for grabs. You know, you either do them or you don't. It's not that I don't care, but it's certainly your call. You're all adults. All right? I'm just hoping you make a good living and can retire before you're 95 years old. All right, here's another one. We encourage demos at the customer premise. The seeing, touching, and feeling of handsets is monumental. You can't see, touch, or feel licenses, or edge marks, or bandwidth. But when I used to love, the minute they put their hand on that phone, I'm counting the money.
Ching, ching.
I'm counting the money. Okay, I'm going to go through an episode here we call transference. I owned 10 wireless stores about 10 years ago. And our mantra was, is put the phone in their hand. The minute they took it, done.
It's the puppy dog clothes.
That's part of it. I have the puppy dog clothes here. By J. Douglas Edwards. Okay? Actually, you know, used to know the other 11 by heart. All right? Let's go on. We encourage webinars, the administrative portal, the call center portal, the call flow portal. If they have an IT person and they're getting 24 phones or more, the administrative portal becomes a huge selling point. So if they want us to go to them to see it, that's fine. If they want to do it via webinar, we've closed more deals just doing that, and people see how it works. This is how you change people, how you change policy, okay? And reports on call centers, all those. We do them for call centers all the time. That's how we get the deals, okay? We do site surveys. If you have a situation where you think it's a little bit complex or you think you just want to put a little fluff on the customer, we'll do a site survey. The technician goes into the room and goes, I think this will work really great in here. That's how I used to do them. No, I got to tell you.
Can I have one today?
Yes, you have one today.
Oh, okay.
All right? As a matter of fact, when I sold long distance service, I used to do this because I'm not that technical. All right? But I used to say, listen, do you have a moment? I'd just like to go into the phone room. I mean, I'm selling minutes. All right? And I would go in there and I'd move a couple of wires again. I said, this is really great. I think this is totally compatible. Let's go back to your desk. I don't even know what the hell I was looking at, I swear to God. But I used to do it all the time, and they thought that I was like God's gift to long distance. All right, we do site surveys, ladies and gentlemen. We deliver proposals as a rule, okay? This is our, again, this is a rule. You can do them, sometimes you can't. We believe that you will get more closes if you do it, all right? And by the way, what word do you not see in that last line? We deliver proposals versus what?
Quotes.
And I'm going to spend a few minutes with you right now discerning the difference between a proposal and a quote. Okay? See this number? I asked Eric. Okay? Eric goes on demos. He can't wait to go on demos. We gave him 4 phones in his trunk. Are they still there?
Yeah.
All right. To go on demos. All he is chartered to do, or me, or other people, or some of our technicians if you need them, is to go see your customers with you. Okay? Obviously in hopes the fact that you're going to turn them to with us. Obviously. But the point of the matter is, we'll take our chances. All right? We'll go out there with you. Because Eric knows our company. So if you're promoting our company. He knows the company. He's got the collateral. Bring the phone out. He'll plug the phone in. And if the customer wants to keep it for a week, they can. We got no problem with this because the transference issue of them seeing the phones. And you know what's interesting? You know, all know what the Polycom phones look like and even the Yealinks and all these other ones, right? How much different do they look than those 14-year-old Nortels on their desk? I put it right next to that old boat anchor, and they go, ooh, that's a nice phone. Done. All right? That's a nice phone because they're comparing it to this thing they've had on there. Remember, you know, with the paper tapes with people's names on them? The ones that say that most of the people on those paper tapes don't even work there anymore? All right? Bring the phone. All right? It's the only tangible asset that we actually have. And that's what they're buying. Right? Okay? All right, let's go on. 90%. Guys, you can't argue with this. And these are, you know, TCG demos that Eric has gone on or other people, and we end up closing those deals generally. Okay. There's a little checklist. I don't know who put this in there. I think it was my boss. I don't even like that. All right. This is what I want to talk about. I want to talk about transference. Any action, guys, any action that goes back and forth between you and your prospect is transference. What if they give you an appointment? Is that transference? What have they transferred? Time, right? You must have said something over the phone or they're interested enough at the get-go to allow you to come in. Is that a good thing? Whoops. Return. How about when they give you the bills? Is that a good thing? Right? If you walk out of a person's office without their bills, you're screwed. How do you even know what they have? All right? And I'm going to back this up and, yeah, email them. They'll email you the bills. That's close. All right? I'm waiting for some from 1980. I got some coming from 1980. I'm still waiting. No, through the mail. And I'm going to send it to your house. All right? If they start asking you questions, is that a good sign? Yes. Huh? Okay. No. If they want to demo the phones, is that a good sign? No. If they request a proposal, is that a good sign? All right. And if they want to know if you have any references that they can talk to.
That doesn't say references.
What?
That doesn't say references.
It says reference address. Thank you, Renee. I appreciate that. Well done. Your site survey's been canceled for this afternoon. And your gift card has been retrieved. But really, thank you very much for noticing. All right, questions to consider. All right, you know, everybody's been through sales 101 in their lives. Would you agree? Right? Everybody's been through sales 101. You people are not new to the selling business. And you know that you can't just say, let me do a quote for you, give me the bills. Right? You have to do something else. Whether you do it or not is up to you. How can you not ask at least a few of these relevant questions to show that you either know what you're talking about or actually care about this person? Okay? Are some of these questions relevant? Right? How about how many people travel? What is that an indicator of? If you have a lot of people that travel, what am I going to propose to you? Mobile link or UC so they can stay on the grid. Right? How would you like to have these people be connected to you no matter where they are in the world? By extension. You can do that? There's number one. All right? Who's the ISP? You want to know what they have today. What are they doing? And you know, it's all about the contracts and everything else. But how many locations do you have? Because you want to propose how many of them?
All of them.
You may not get all of them, but you might get what? Most of them. You might get even one. All right? Yeah, hold that thought. All right, so these are some questions. And you know what? I'm not that smart. I used to go in with these questions written down. So I wouldn't do what? Forget them. Hamana, hamana, hamana. You know, let me do a quote. You know, I sit there and you know, you sit there like this. You got to show people that you have some sincerity and some technique. Because you're telling them all about these great things you have, and you're walking out of there as fast as you possibly can. All right? How about this one? How do you think most people would answer that?
Their cells. Huh? Use your cells.
You go to your cell phone. Yep. Mm-hmm. And what about the people that call you up?
Yep.
How are they going to get you? Call forwarding with your premise-based phone system? that has no service? You have no FPL?
Set up call forwarding on analog lines.
No.
It takes forever.
All right.
Come on.
It's just like Mr. Call Forwarding over here. The point of the matter is, the point of the matter is that everybody's interested, ladies and gentlemen, in DR. Okay? Business continuity and disaster recovery are the biggest hot buttons in business today. And if you can automate that function by either putting in a separate bandwidth circuit, right, having hosted PBX, having call forwarding unreachable on your phone, or having your auto attendant in the sky, whatever it is. All right, but what would happen, Eric? What do you do when you show? How do you show this to a customer?
Take my IP phone, unplug the internet connection, and say, okay, call the phone. They call it, of course, it rings my UC instantaneously, and then I do the same thing with the power. Power out. So once your power's out of the phone, then that works.
What do you do? So it's a beautiful demo.
And I said, can I do that to your phone?
Yeah, as fundamental as it is, it's a scare tactic. But it's also relevant, is it not? Because cloud PBXs and unified communications are better at keeping businesses in business. Period. All right? All right, I'm not going to go through all this. You know, this is six or eight good reasons why you don't ever want to sell a premise-based system again. Sorry if you do. All right? Fact. Okay. I know. No offense. Fact. Business owners would love to have a new phone system. Would you agree? Everybody would love to have a new phone system. I'll tell you straight out. Love to have a new phone system. They just don't want to buy one. Now here comes the rub. How do we get someone who wants a phone system, without having to buy it? All right? So now you're on stage. This is how we do it. All right? First of all, let's talk about money. Everybody talks about money because it's what? The easiest thing to talk about. It's quantifiable. It's relatable. Right? Okay. This is generally some information done about the total cost of ownership on a premise-based PBX versus hosted. It takes about 3 years to get it back. Okay? All right, how many people ask you this? How much is it going to cost me? Some form of this question. How much is it going to be? How much is this going to cost me? How much is it? How much? So, do you answer the question right there? It's going to be $450 a month, give or take, 100. Plus tax, makes it 800.
When you say per seat, it doesn't sound
right. Okay. Here's the equation that I hope you all employ. There's a little known fact that your prospects are already spending money on telecom. Do you understand that? They're already spending money. They have PRIs, they have analog lines, they have maintenance on their phones, they have cellular bills. They have everything, right? They got somebody accounting, they got IT people, they got phone people, they got everything. They're paying bills up the what? I'll leave that blank. All right? That's a good one. All right? But the point is, they're already spending money. So when you give them a quote, and this to me is the pet peeve of the century, when you give them a quote, your quote somewhere in there, your proposal somewhere in there should suggest the delta or the difference between what they're paying now and what you're proposing that they do for their new system. It might be less, right? It might be a little bit more. But it's not going to be the $800 that's on your quote. It's the equation. Is anybody understanding this? Mm-hmm. All right? If you don't employ this equation, then it becomes a tougher pill to swallow. Because when you give them your quote and it says $740, including all of our stuff, what do they think it's costing them? They think it's $740 a month. They multiply it times 12, and it's $10,000 a year. Not to mention the $14,000 a year they're already spending. That will do what when you implement?
Go away.
It will go away. Don't start with me. All right?
Most of the time, you're going to end up being less anyways than what they're currently.
Potentially. Spending. But it doesn't matter. Whatever it is, this is the equation. Sometimes it's going to be more. Because you're going to propose a Metro E or something to replace a PRI. I mean, yada, yada, yada. And the other thing is that, you know, bandwidth is another thing to think about. When they are adding $500 worth of more bandwidth, what are they getting? You're not replacing the PRI. What are they getting? They're getting a 10 or 20 meg circuit. What do they think? The other 18, you know, the other 16 megs around the house? You're a really good guy, Paul. You know, here's 18 megs. I'll pay it. It's my pleasure. All right? Just for those 7 phones you're putting in. All right, let's go on. Everybody capisce this? All right? So how many, here's the ballpark question. How many decision makers know how much they're spending per month? Good answer. All right? They think they do. They haven't looked at it in a long time, right? They just don't know. So the only way that the two of you engaged in this opportunity are going to find out how much you're spending is to do what? Okay, get the bills. Get all the bills. Nothing but the bills. So help me God. Okay? Multiple bills for different locations. They're getting all kinds of them. ISP costs, cellular bills. What happens? We have customers that have bought our service because their cell phone bills went down by 80% because they stopped using what to call Peru? LD from their cell phones. They put a phone in Peru, they have one here, and how much is it to call each other? Ungats. And the guy's sending me dozens of roses. I wish he'd stop. It's 3 years already. He spent the money on roses that he would have been on the cell bill. All right? But in any event, these are some of the hidden things. You know, people say, you know, people with 80 phones, they say, well, my phone system's already paid for. Yes, it is. But what do you think they're paying per month to their interconnect company? $3 per phone per month maintenance. The guy's laughing all the way to the bank. So he's paying $240 a month just for maintenance and never hasn't used it in 5 years. And they don't make the phones anymore. Nobody told them. Okay. So you got to get the bills, ladies and gentlemen. Okay? So money is the X factor because it is quantifiable and it gets people's juices flowing. So these are the kinds of things when you do your proposal, I believe, whether we do it for you or not, you should add it in there as their consultant to let them know what the delta is. Right? All right, because I can't do that because I don't get the bills. You get the bills. You need to do the math. Okay? So at the end of the day, ready for this? This is what I couldn't believe it. So at the end of the day, for about the same money or a little bit more or less, they get a brand new, state-of-the-art, feature-rich, scalable, enterprise-grade, supported, integrated, future-proof, disaster-proof, one-bill-to-pay, productive, all-inclusive, freaking phone system. All right? I'm getting a headache. But am I right? You know, this is just between us chickens here. But this is what it is. Now, how do we transfer this enthusiasm to these guys, to these buyers, so they get off the schneid? And you can make some real money. Okay? So, a proposal is more than a quote. Okay? This is a big message. A proposal defines the experience of conversion, all right? A quote just tells you how much it's going to be, right? What's included in the experience of conversion from my old PBX to this one? What's going to happen here? How does it happen? What happens? Guy signs up. Now what happens? He's scared out of his mind. He doesn't know what's going to happen. Is that correct? You walk out of the office, they're clicking your heels 3 times, doing cartwheels all the way to your car, right? Trying to figure out, where am I going to spend this money? Right? And this guy's freaking out. So you have to tell them there's a technique and a strategy called selling past the sale. And that is telling them what's going to happen even before they sign. This is what's going to happen. We're going to process the order. A project manager will get it. They will communicate back to you, introducing themselves, and they're responsible for the whole implementation. We're not the only company that does this. We hope we do it better. But this is the process. Then our technicians are going to come here and do a site survey. Then we're going to get the phones ready. Then we're going to bring them out, and then the porting, and then the training, and then all the stuff. These are the steps. So when you leave the office, they know that there's a process in place. And I think it's important that they know this before that, because I think it'll increase the number of signatures you get. You buying into this at all? All right? I mean, you can patronize me. I don't care. This is me. But I think it makes a lot of sense to let them know what's going to happen even before they buy. It's a great trick to let them know how it's going to feel once they sign, what's going to happen here. Everybody gets in motion. And it's going to happen in about 45 days, and this is what it happens. There's a timeline in our proposals to set the expectations correctly. All right? Okay. I'm a big advocate of not offering just too many options. You can't email five quotes to somebody. Whatever your modus operandi is, listen, I like to pick one, maybe two. I don't care. Hopefully it's us and nobody else. If it's us and somebody else, that's fine. But to send somebody multiple quotes is just too cumbersome.
They only care about their needs.
They only care about their needs. Okay?
Whatever the pain is, just go to that and make your suggestion more than that. Make a suggestion and
run with it.
Run with it.
I couldn't agree more.
You are the expert. Don't just throw things out there because it's just going to complicate things.
I'll say one thing. A customer, in my experience, feels more comfortable when they see that I can bring them a variety of four or five different providers, okay? I'm not going to say I will weave out which one is best for them. And I'll say it, most of the time it's IP phone.
I appreciate that. But to your point, to Renee's point, I appreciate that. But I think it's incumbent on you to get down to the nitty with them, okay?
Sure, yeah.
I mean, it's good. Maybe you get them some, but at the end of the time, you're going to make your consultative, decision for them. This is my belief.
Sure.
This is why you brought me in here, right? I'm not trying to change habits that you have and stuff works for you. Please be my, don't change for me. I'm just trying to give you a little added stuff here. Pick the one you like, okay? All right. Going back to the basics here. Deliver that proposal, okay? Discuss the implementation process to reduce fear. I just mentioned that, okay? Okay. Closing sales. These things work. The demo will help you get more sales. Showing value will get you more sales. The timing, when is it a good time? Don't try to wedge your way into somebody when they're doing a move of all their computers. You're just not going to get the attention you deserve. All right? References sell. Do you all have references that you can go to? How about testimonial letters? Do you have a letter that says that you're the good guy, we like doing business with you, I recommend you to other people? Do you have those? If you don't, please get them. We have a lot of them. I got a book of them. I bring them with me on every single sales call. I have a dozen testimonial letters. I just give them to the prospect here, and they fumble through them. They close them up, and they go, so tell me a little more. I don't even say a word. I know when to shut up. Let them read the letters. Oh, you have these guys? Who's that? Some of the letters I wrote myself, they're really, really good. Dearest Stu. All right, let's go on here. Here's your big puppy dog clothes, bud. Okay? Here's some of the things you can do. If you're not going to get the whole enchilada, if you can't make a wholesale implementation, ask for one small office, right? Because getting one small office makes them a what? A customer versus a what?
Prospect.
A prospect. Big move. Everything else is add-ons. Okay? I don't care if you sell them one phone. They become a customer. They're in the bills. All right? Okay? Have the owner or manager take a phone home with them if they don't want to use them there. Just figure something out to get that piece of plastic in their hand. Okay? And that's the old puppy dog clothes, because once they try it and try it again, what do they say? Can you leave this one here and get me the rest of them? Certainly. Okay? All right, I'm going to have the big ending right now. This goes away from telecom, away from UC. This is from me to you, okay? Did this for a living for many, many years, and I'm going to do that voodoo that I do so well, okay? Secrets to top salespeople, and that's, by the way, what you are, in case you forgot. The best time to make a sale is right after you made a sale. Agreed? How do you feel when you make a sale? I think it's like, what, the third best feeling there is? One told me that it's the best feeling ever. I told him to get a life. I had one guy say it was seventh. We hung out. All right. Be knowledgeable about your product and your industries. I've been talking to you about this most of the morning here today. The more you know, the more you know. All right? The more times you won't have to say, I'll have to find out. Or I'm not sure. Because weakness is a no-go. Okay? Develop and maintain a system that works for you and work it. Self-analysis, I know, keeps you sharp. Mm-hmm. You are your own
purpose.
You are your own boss. The responsibility lies with you, right? I'm not telling you what time to wake up and how many people to call and all this kind of stuff. You're grown-ups. Okay? Sales is not a 9-to-5 job. Everybody knows that. It's about 10-to-3 with a 2-hour lunch. If a guy comes to you and says, listen, I'm really, really busy, but how about it? Can you come over Saturday morning at 9 to my office? What would you say?
Sure.
Huh? Absolutely.
Yeah. I'll be there.
This is what we signed up for. If you want a 9-to-5 job, there's none available.
Coffee and bagels.
Okay? I know some people say, well, how many phones is it?
One.
All right. Prospecting and networking is nonstop. Close on every call. It's the law. Fill your appointment book every week, no matter what. Make sure you have a busy week because you got to have prospects because they just don't all buy. Okay? Sorry to give you that news. All right? Always ask for referrals. Make more calls. Hard work pays off, ladies and gentlemen. And make every call you make the best one you're ever going to make because even you might sell something. Okay? Here's your distribution. You got to get this lined up. As an entrepreneur, you have to have direct sales, the ones you make. Your network, the people you hang out with who can help you get deals, and your customers, use them as leverage. Why do you deserve a referral? Okay? Turn your customers into your ambassadors. Make friends with them. If they've done the right thing, make sure you tell your friends. Always leave a half a dozen cards with a prospect or customer. What's the worst thing they can do with those cards? Throw them out. You got plenty more. Okay? Okay, and lastly, this is our commitment to TCG partners. Let me get to this. Sorry. Whoops. Oh, yeah. Our aggressive quarterly incentives, dedicated channel management, dedicated help desk, demos always available, and we have a sales engineer for Complex. These are available to all of you all the time. All right? Everybody knows you have 6 days left to get 4X. God forbid you should sell a sale 500 or more. All right? Okay? We have, you know, we try our best to offer as much as possible to you. But the interesting part is that first you make the sale, then you get the money. Okay? It's an interesting equation. First you make the sale, then you get the money. Because some people say, what's the spiff? I said, where's your order? Okay? I got the spiff. You got the order? No, I'm kidding with you, but that's the way it works, right? Because salespeople don't make money. We make sales. The companies give you the money. It's a great setup. You don't have to call, you don't have to count it, nothing. It just comes.
So that's ending this month.
That is, yes. There'll be another one coming out for fourth quarter, but I'm not in.
So if you promise the customer a free month, if they don't sign by the end of this month, then.
Yeah, unless it comes on next month. But we'll see. We always have we have one. It's not gelled yet. Okay. But also, we're very, 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 very proud, and Dan is very, 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 very happy that we have offered up the trip to Turks and Caicos for any TCG agent that sells 250 licenses before the end of January. Could be in how many sales? It could be one. It could be in 250 for all I care, if you want to do that much writing. All right? But it's available, and we're very happy to do it. And I talked to Damien, our CEO, and he hopes he gives away 50 trips. Okay? And I'm going. Just kidding. All right? So, you know, we're on your team. And this is my big ending here. Here's the top 10 reasons to make money. You can buy lots of stuff. You can eat in restaurants. You can keep gas in your car. You can feed your whole family. You can take vacation outside of your own zip code. You can feel what it's like to valet park. You can actually watch a sporting event outside of your home. You can retire before 80. You can write with pens not stolen from hotels. And the number one reason to have money is so that you can keep up with the Kardashians. And living well is the best revenge. Life is too short to drink cheap beer, period. Remember, there's a lot of dollars out there for you if you learn how to sell it right. And what's in your wallet? All right. It's a true partnership. I guess there's no comments because everybody's hungry. Thanks for your time today.